So hello everyone and welcome to the yearly Q&A. Now, just like last year and the year before that, I've asked you if you have any questions you would like me to answer in this yearly Q&A, and you guys have left quite a few questions, so let's get right to them. Question number one by Mr. Nesiske Bellig, and he asks, what is your favorite video you have made? Now, this is a pretty hard question for me because I try to make every video better than the previous one. I always try to improve on them. But if I were to go with one, it's probably the original Ultimate Resource Farming Guide, because that was kind of like a big step up for me in terms of video production. Because up until then, when I did farming videos, I would do the resources one by one, but when they changed the star chart and made farming a little bit more obvious, I didn't think that was good enough anymore. And they kind of kickstarted the whole, you know, each video has to be better than the previous one. So instead of doing the resources one by one, I decided to pour a lot more time into this video and just make one big video. And it worked out. You guys really seemed to like it. It was a very popular video and I'm very happy with how it turned out. So that's probably my favorite one. Question number two by Mr. Agent 1220, which is your favorite stance? I'm gonna go with Temple Royale because it kind of has a little bit of everything, or a lot of everything, yeah? It has really good weapons that go with it. You have all the heavy blades, you know, Sindo, Sindo Prime, Galatine, Galatine Prime, and all that stuff. So it has really fun weapons that go with it. It has a lot of mobility, and that's something that I really like in stances. I don't like stances that slow you down too much. The combos look absolutely amazing, especially the block combo with the slam. It feels impactful and it's just a really fun stance overall, so definitely Temple Royale. Question number three by Mr. DD Zalos 2. Where do you live and where are you from? I am from Czech Republic and I still live in Czech Republic. It is beautiful. Not a lot of people actually realize that. A lot of people from Czech Republic go like on holidays somewhere else in another country. But Czech Republic is really nice. Well, it kind of depends where you live, because there is like a big part of Czech Republic where it's nothing but flat land and not much of anything else, just factories and cities. But where I live, it's just forests all around and a couple of hills here and there. It is really nice here. And it's even better if you go into the mountains, because Czech Republic really has some marvelous mountains. Question number four by Mr. ANG the Chaos Servant. If you could choose which frame is going to get primed next, who would you choose? I'm gonna go with Atlas, not only because, you know, I use him as my YouTube icon and my glyph icon and he's really fun overall, but also because I'm really curious as to how they would remake him into a primed version, because with a lot of Warframes, you have some obvious parts that can be spruced up, you know, made a little bit more ornamental and turn them gold to sort of give off the feeling of it being a primed version of that frame. But Atlas is just a beefed up dude, so what do you do with Atlas? Give him golden muscles? So that's something that I'm really curious about. How are they going to basically decorate Atlas to make him look like a primed frame? So yeah, definitely Atlas. Question number five by Mr. Okay But Why Though. That's a lovely name. Did you always have this relaxing voice? Of course not. Your voice changes over time, especially for men. It's kind of like a fine wine, it just gets bitter with time. Question number six by Mr. Psycho Royce. Do you have any plans to change or keep your name? No, I don't. I've had it for a very long time. This YouTube channel was made in March 2011, so it's almost 7 years old now. And I think it would just confuse people more than anything, so no plans to change it. I also kind of like the YouTube name, you know, MCGamerCZ. That's a mighty fine name for YouTube. There are people that have far worse names on YouTube than me. Question number seven by Mr. Exodia Bravo. I'd like to ask a general personal question. How old are you? I am 27 years old right now. Question number eight by Mr. Etrionas. I just want to know your opinion on the conversion rates for your country and if you think the prices for Prime Access should be adjusted for people in your country slash region. I don't think so, because the conversion rates fluctuate a lot, so it would be a never-ending process and it would just be too much of a hassle in my opinion. It's kind of a weird situation because every country has a different sort of average wage, so how do you calculate that? I don't think it's worth the hassle, honestly. Question number nine by Mr. The Suck Duck. Do you enjoy the idea of Zoos and would you like the introduction of primary, secondary and maybe even Warframe Zoos? Well, first of all, how would you even do Warframe Zoos? That sounds way too complicated for it to be worth it. Primary and secondary Zoos, maybe eventually, but I don't think we need them. But when it comes to melee zones, I think it was a great idea and it was executed fairly well as well. I didn't quite get them at first. I was like, well, why would I put so much time and resources into something that's probably not gonna be as good as the other melee weapons that we have? But then I thought about it a little bit more and I actually made a couple of zones and I realized that it kind of takes the melee weapon system and flips it on its head. Because instead of you getting a weapon, looking at the stats and then coming up with a build that would suit the weapon, you do the exact opposite. You come up with a build that you like to use and you build a weapon around that. And I like that. It gives you more freedom. It allows you to play the way you want. Question number 10 by Mr. Garrett Norton. What attributes to Warframe's longevity in your opinion and what has kept you interested for so long? I enjoy the contentful updates that add something new for the veterans and improve the mechanics of the game almost every time, though I am curious as to how a veteran such as yourself would never get bored of this albeit wonderful game. And I think there is a lot that contributes to the longevity of Warframe. The complexity of it is one thing in my opinion, because what I've noticed over the years of gaming is the more complex a game is and the more you have to invest yourself in it to understand it, the more likely you are to stick with that game. Then there is the sheer amount of stuff you can do and get in Warframe, because especially nowadays, with Planes of Eidolon, if you get bored of just playing normal mission, you can go to the planes and it feels completely different, so there is always something else you can do. Then there is the community. It's always good to have a healthy community in an online game, which Warframe definitely has. That's something that I think keeps a lot of people playing. And then of course there are the developers. If the developers are incompetent and they don't communicate with the community, it's not gonna put a lot of confidence in the community that the game is gonna keep growing. And DE have done a wonderful job communicating with the community via dev streams and stuff, and they pump out constant updates, so that's a huge part of it as well, I think. And as for how I keep myself interested in the game, because I have been playing it for a couple of years now, and it's basically I try to do everything. Yeah, it's very easy to just not do stuff, to assume that it's not gonna appeal to you and just leave it alone. I, for example, was never really interested in melee stances when they first came out. I would always just use the button mash combo and that was it. But as time went on, I started to do the pause combos and the charge combos, and I realized that it's a lot of fun to actually, you know, try to pull off combos during missions. It's far more fun than just mashing the melee button. I found it so interesting that I started making videos about the stances, which spawned the stance playlist, which at the moment has showcased every single stance in the game. And it became one of my favorite things to do, just the process of getting a new stance, learning the combos, and then learning to pull them off in a mission and then making a video about it and all that. And it's something that I originally thought I would never be interested in. Now there are of course things that I've tried and ended up not liking, like raids. I just don't like raiding in Warframe, which is kind of weird because I was a big raider back in World of Warcraft, but I ended up liking most of the things that the game had to offer, so I would definitely recommend you try everything and just stick to what you like, because it's far too easy to do nothing and then complain there is nothing to do. Question number 11 by Mr. Mark Hopkins. Other than collecting recording for your videos, what do you do to entertain yourself in Warframe once you've reached the level of game you are at? It's basically the same answer, but I'm gonna phrase it differently. You have to make your own fun, because once you've gathered most of the things in Warframe and you have like millions of resources like I do, and you've done 3-hour survivals and 100 waves of defense, you have to find something that's fun for you, and that's gonna differ from person to person. For me, it's playing around with wonky builds and rolling weird ribbons and stuff like that. For someone else, it might be doing long survivals or long defense or even a defection or whatever it is. Just find the thing that's fun for you and do that. Don't let other people tell you how you should have fun, because you are the person that knows the best how to have fun. It's kind of like the Minecraft thing. Minecraft is a wonderful game and I love Minecraft to death, and it has endless hours of entertainment, but people play Minecraft differently. They enjoy different things. Some people like survival mode, some people like creative mode, some people play adventure maps, some people play with mod packs, and on and on and on. And it's the same with Warframe. You have to try everything, figure out what's fun, and do that. Question number 12 from Mr. Variable Cross. What's the most fun weapon that most people might have forgotten about from primaries, secondaries, and melee? Now, I don't know if these were really forgotten by people, I can't really tell, but I think it's the Strun series from primary weapons, because it's just a really fun shotgun that I think has been overshadowed by other shotguns. For secondaries, I'm gonna say the Staticor, which is a really fun weapon that I don't see used at all. And for melee? Ooh. I don't really know. I have no idea what's like a really fun but forgotten melee weapon. I honestly don't know. Question number 13 by Minoaka Keichi? Are you married? No, I am not. Question number 14 by Mr. Hitspot. Can you make it to 100k this year? Already did, my friend. Already did. Question number 15 by Navar Ali. Happy holidays. Do you have any good advice for a new Warframe YouTuber? And I'm gonna say the same thing I always say. Do it for fun. Don't expect to make money because that will most likely lead to disappointment. And be consistent. YouTube is all about consistency. You're not gonna attract a lot of people when you release a video like every other day and then you don't release a video for a week and then you release one video and then nothing for a week and then two videos. You just need to be consistent for people to stick around. When my YouTube channel started growing like 2 years ago when I started doing Warframe stuff, I was just terrified of taking a break and I didn't miss a day for like 6 months. I would release one video every day. I would do nothing but YouTube. And I think that's one of the biggest things that helped my channel grow as much as it did. I don't do that anymore because I'm putting way more time into videos nowadays because I just want to make them the best I can. So sometimes there just isn't enough time in the day to finish the video. But I think it's extremely important to be consistent in the beginning. And don't get me wrong, you don't have to release a video every day. That's just what I did. You can release it every other day, every 2 days, or every Wednesday. Just make it so that people can go, okay, it's Wednesday, I'm pretty sure he's released a video and they're gonna check your channel out. You just have to be consistent in some way. Question number 16 by Manuel Palaiologo. Warframe is a game which has a player base with many differing opinions about the game systems. Therefore, I like to know which are the things you hate about Warframe and also love. Well, what I hate about Warframe is the amount of countermeasures the developers had to put in to counteract how overpowered we are. You know, basically every faction having multiple enemies that can knock you down or teleport you around in the case of the commanders, or grapple your weapon, disable your abilities and stuff like that. Basically something that nerfs you without nerfing you directly. This is why I am terrified whenever they add something stupidly overpowered and why I don't like it and I always call it out, because it's shit like that that makes things like nullifiers happen, right? We don't have stupidly overpowered abilities on Warframes because there are nullifiers to counteract that. It's the other way around. We have nullifiers because we have stupidly overpowered abilities. But the developers have to keep us in check, so they have to add something like nullifiers, which ultimately aren't that much fun to fight. They are better nowadays because you can pop their bubble by shooting the little drone, but yeah, I would rather just fight normal enemies. And what I love about Warframe is the freedom. I can pick virtually any weapon I can imagine and do whatever I want with it, and that's just awesome. Question number 17 by that Confederate bastard. Are you excited for Loki Prime unvaulting in January? Space Mom just confirmed it on Twitter. Personally, no, not really, because I already have Loki Prime, but it's really awesome for people that don't already have him. And that's pretty much all I can say about that. Moving on. Question number 18 by Dalkar1. What made you get into Warframe so much? Well, I think one of the reasons was how the game has improved, because when I first downloaded it after watching Total Biscuit's WTF is Warframe a few years back, it was very bare bonesy. I got all the way to Vor and I killed him back when he was still just a, I think it was a red butcher with a stun stick. It was just a reskin enemy. And that was pretty much it. That's all I did. And I uninstalled the game and I haven't played it for a while. But then I downloaded it again and it has improved so much. I was blown away. So I got into it a little bit more and I started researching stuff and I started learning all the different things they have added. And that was definitely one of the things, the fact that the developers cared and they actually improved the game a lot. And I just kept delving deeper and deeper into the game as I was getting bored with WoW and I was looking for a new game to play. And I got to the point, because there is a point with games like Warframe where you just get sucked in and it's all you want to do. Where I got into the rhythm of seeing a weapon and being like, oh wow, that looks really cool. And then, you know, I would try to figure out how to get the weapon and I would get it and I would make a build for it and I would play around with it. But then I would see another weapon, I'd be like, oh wow, that looks cool as well. And, you know, it just kept going on and on and on, and here we are. Question number 19 by Mr. Kitaro Watches. Just wanted to ask, are there any games coming up that you would want to play? Not really. I haven't been really excited about a game coming out in a very long time. And I think it's because the AAA industry has turned into this money-grabbing spawn of Satan that makes games just to make money, so most of the games are very bland and shit. And the smaller indie devs that are actually making interesting games don't really have the money to advertise them properly, so I don't really hear about the games before they come out. Question number 20 by Tyro. What do you think about Destiny and Destiny 2? Oh man, Destiny 2. I really, really wanted Destiny 2 to be good because I love first-person games. Yeah, third-person games are fine, but I just love first-person games. And a first-person RPG shooter, that's right up my alley because I'm a big fan of Borderlands. So the idea of it being essentially online Borderlands that's constantly updated by the devs, you know, and you get more and more content as time goes on, was really good. That was right up my alley. But, you know, AAA industry, Activision Blizzard, they ballsed it up and they made it somewhat enjoyable at the start until it's not anymore. It just gets repetitive and they want to milk as much money out of you as possible. It's really sad. I honestly, honestly wanted that game to be good because that's the kind of game that I would lose my life to. Question number 21 by Tovarish Karlov. Will you ever do a meetup? I don't know, maybe one day. I never thought about... Would you guys be interested in something like that? I never even thought about something like a meetup. Let me know if you would be interested in something like that. Question number 22 from Mr. Chaotic Monk. What weapons from other games you would love to be in Warframe and why? Mine is a dual glaive from an old PS3 game called Kingdoms of Amalur Reckoning. Oh my god, yes. Glaives in that game were awesome. I always ended up playing glaives because they were just so much fun to use. So yeah, that would be fun. That would be really fun. I can't think of anything else. Maybe the super shotgun from Doom? Yeah, the super shotgun from Doom. That'd be awesome. But the glaive from Kingdoms of Amalur Reckoning would be awesome as well. Question number 23 by Alex Swatsky. What are some bands / music that you like? Well, I generally prefer metal, but I will listen to anything as long as it has a nice kick to it or a nice melody. And lately I've been listening to a lot of Black Dahlia Murders. That's a really cool band. Question number 24 by Mr. DS Log. Do you have any other games that you want to do videos on? And yes, I do. I would like to make more videos about Elder Scrolls Online because I'm a huge Elder Scrolls nerd, but it just takes way too much time away from Warframe, so I can't really do that, unfortunately. Question number 25 by Maxer4000. What kind of players grind your gears? Vegan min-maxers is the name I have given them. They're not your standard min-maxers, and there is nothing wrong about min-maxing. You can min-max all you want if that's how you have fun. But the vegan min-maxer is the type of min-maxer that won't shut up about it, yeah? They tell everyone how awesome they are and how right they are at everything and how wrong everyone else is for having fun in other ways. That's why I call them vegan min-maxers. Question number 26 by Sean Potato. What is your favorite Warframe to use? Well, lately I've been enjoying Inaros a lot because I like tanky Warframes, and Inaros is probably the tankiest. But in terms of just fun and enjoyment, I'm gonna go with the Nidus. However, I play with a lot of different Warframes. I switch them around constantly, and the reason why you might see some Warframes pop up more than others in my videos, like Rhino and Inaros, is because, well, I like tanks, but also because they make more sense when showcasing weapons. Those two frames don't take any attention away from the weapons. You just put on Iron Skin or Scarab armor and just focus on the weapon and how it performs in game. It would be a really bad sort of spotlight / review if I showcased the weapon on Ember and had World on Fire turned on. Or showcase a melee weapon on like Loki, Ivara or Ashe and constantly be invisible so you can't see the animations. That's basically the reason why I showcase most of my weapons on either Inaros, Rhino or even Wukong. Oh yeah, and Valkyr, of course. Question number 27 by X Renas. What do you think of more open areas in Warframe? Well, I would definitely like to see more areas like Plains. I think Plains is a lot of fun. And the one I would like to see the most, probably, is Eris. I would love to see what they would do with an infested landscape. That would be awesome, I think. Question number 28 from Big Biggie. As a chef, I used to be a chef, by the way, what is your favorite recipe to cook? Steaks. All kinds of steaks. It doesn't just have to be beef. I just love cooking steaks. I don't know why. It's just more fun than cooking anything else. And I like to keep it simple. I don't like overcomplicating steaks because it kind of hides away the flavor of the meat, which is, you know, what you want to taste in a steak. You want the meat to be the star of the dish. So it's just olive oil in a pan, you season the steak, you sear the steak on both sides, you add in a bit of rosemary, bit of garlic maybe even, or a bit of thyme if you want to. You add a bit of butter, you baste the steak, and you leave it to rest. You know, medium, medium rare, done. That's basically it. Nothing too complicated. That's for beef, of course. If I'm doing something like chicken, I will usually do it with lemon. And if I'm doing pork, I like to do it with sweet bell peppers. That is an awesome combination. Question number 29 from Chris Mush. How do you go about choosing what weapons do you or do you not make videos for, and approximately how much time it takes to make a single video? So I generally like to make videos about everything. I don't like to exclude weapons or frames. But I do tend to prefer or make videos about weapons that are really fun first. And as far as how long it takes to make a video, it depends. It really depends. The shortest or the quickest ones are the Barokatir videos. Those are usually somewhere from 1 to 2 hours, depending on the size of his inventory and how many like cosmetic clips I have to record on my orbiter. But it's generally somewhere between 4 to 8 hours. It really depends on the type of the video. The one that took the longest in one single day was the Cephalon fragment one, which was well over 10 hours. But it's mostly because I had to get the fragments first. And the one that took the most time overall was either the Ultimate Resource Farming Guide or the Fishing Guide for Eidolon. Those took a couple of weeks, if I include doing the research and progressing through everything and doing the farming. Question number 30 from Raccoon Freeman. If you could make your own Warframe, what would you call it and what would its abilities be? Well, I don't know what I would call it, but I would like to see a proper necromancer, like a demon frame that summons whatever. Not like a necros type of necromancer, but an actual like a summoner. That's something that we don't quite have yet, and it's something that would be really awesome, I think. Question number 31 from Missile Cuddlesworth, and this is more of a game question. So can you explain the old relic farming system, mainly for Loki, because he's getting unvaulted soon and I wasn't around for that type of farming? Well, here's the thing, it's actually gonna be updated, so it's gonna be the same as everything else. Yeah, you don't have to worry about anything, he's gonna get his own relics, you're gonna farm the relics and then you're gonna crack them in fissure missions. Question number 32 by The Suck Duck. Didn't we have Suck Duck already? Yeah, I think we did, but his question is, what is your favorite movie? And I'm gonna go with either Terminator 2? Or one of the Indiana Jones movies. I don't watch too many movies nowadays, so I'm not very familiar with the newer ones. So yeah, either Terminator 2 or one of the Indiana Jones movies. I love those. Question number 33 by Willy Orta. Here's my question, MC. You've mentioned several times that you were a chef. What prompted you to pursue that in life? Well, I always found it fascinating. I found chefs fascinating. It was just cool to watch them transfer raw ingredients into lovely food. So I wanted to do that as well. I was always helping around the kitchen, you know, helping my mom and my grandma when they were cooking stuff. So I was like, you know what, might as well be a chef. I find it fascinating and it's probably a lot of fun, so let's do it. Question number 34 by Mr. Awesome Bart. Where did you learn to speak English? You sound like you were born in some English-speaking country. Well, thank you. And no, I wasn't. I was born in Czech Republic and I started learning English in the 5th grade in elementary school. And I wasn't very good at it at the start. I was pretty terrible. But then I started playing World of Warcraft. And I started playing, you know, generally more games that were imported from other countries and they weren't translated. So I had to learn English. And when I started playing WoW and I started raiding with the British Guild and I was a tank, I had to speak English to, you know, actually do the raids. So that's where I learned it. That's why I have somewhat of a kind of a British accent mixed in with a Czech accent. Question number 35 by EpicMonk117. Marry, shag and kill Captain Vor, Clem and Ergo Glast. Well, I would shag Vor because he seems very passionate about things. I would marry Clem because he's just a lovely soul. And I would kill Glast for his betrayal. Because the amount of times I was doing a mission for Glass and he was like, ooh, you have to take down the ambulance. And then in the middle of a mission, he was like, you know what? I decided you're bad for a business and send a hit squad after me. Yeah, he deserves to die. Yeah, I remember what you did, Ergo. And I'm coming for you. And it won't be pretty. Question number 36 by Ariel Christian. What do you use for recording? Well, I used to record with NVIDIA Shadowplay and it just seems to get worse and worse with every update. So I switched over to OBS and it's a lot better. And finally, question number 37 by Jerry Ghost. How and when did you become a Warframe player? Well, I became a Warframe player in either January or February of 2013 after watching Total Biscuits' WTF is Warframe. And that is it for the Q&A. So as always, guys, I thank you very much for watching or listening this time around. Have a wonderful new year and I will see you next time. Bye-bye.